Labor Day today, so in honor of Labor Day, maybe you had some cocktails the night before and you're feeling a little hungover, so we're going to do yoga for a hangover, or to help cure it at least. So, we're going to start in extended child's pose. If you have a block, I recommend grabbing it. We're going to just walk the hands forward and rest the forehead on the block. If you don't have a block, just go ahead and rest your forehead on the mat or prop up on your forearms and just keep the neck in line with the spine. We're going to take a few deep breaths, becoming present on the mat, leaving anything that's not serving us off of the mat during our practice. We're going to inhale to the count of four through the nose and exhale to the count of eight through the mouth. Let's inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Let's gently lift our head, move the block to the side, and we're going to bring the left arm underneath the right arm, resting the left ear on the mat, right arm reaching for the top of the mat, prop up on those fingertips, close your eyes, and let's take three deep breaths here. Gently lift your head, slide that arm out, reach for the top of the mat, right arm comes under the left, right ear to the mat, hold for three breaths. Gently lift your head, slide that arm out, and let's come to a tabletop. We're going to do a couple cat-cows. Knees are under the hips, hands under the shoulders, widen the fingers. We're going to arch and open the chest, lift the chin as we inhale. We're going to exhale, round the spine, chin to chest. Inhale, arch and open. Exhale, round, chin to chest. Inhale, arch and open. And exhale, round. We're going to swing the legs around and come into a middle split. Again, your block will come in handy for this. So don't overdo it here just because we're still warming up. You should feel just a slight stretch, no pain. Sit up nice and tall. Flex the feet. And we're going to walk the fingertips forward. If you don't have a block, just rest on your forearms, keeping the neck in line with the spine. If you do have a block, you can rest your forehead wherever it's comfortable and hold for three breaths. Gently lift your head. We're going to walk the fingertips in and we're going to bring the right foot on the inside of the left thigh, sitting up nice and tall. Again, you can use that block on the inside of that shin. Walk the hands forward and rest the forehead. If you do not have a block, just keep that neck in line with the spine. Hold for three breaths. Gently lift the head, walk the fingertips in, and let's switch sides. Right leg out, left foot on the inside of that thigh. Use the block if you have it. Walk the fingertips out, and gently rest the forehead. Take three breaths. stretching poses, you can always keep your knee bent if that's more comfortable. We're gonna bring that right leg behind us. Both sits bones are on the mat. And we're gonna twist over to the left. Keep a nice straight spine. Look over that shoulder. Inhale. And exhale. Let's take it over to the right. Look over that shoulder. Inhale. And exhale. Come through center. Walk the fingertips out. Again, you can use the block to rest your forehead or just keep the neck in line with the spine. Deep inhale. Empty that exhale. Deep inhale. Empty that exhale. One more breath. And let's walk the fingertips up. We're gonna switch legs now. So the left leg comes behind, sitting up nice and tall. We're gonna twist over to the right, straight spine, look over that shoulder. Fill the lungs and empty them. Let's take it to the other side, straight spine. Inhale and exhale. We're gonna walk it forward. Rest that forehead or stay up on the forearms, neck in line with the spine. Take three deep breaths. And let's walk it up. Place the block to the side. Place your hands on the mat and we're gonna come into a tabletop. Come into a down dog, lift the hips towards the sky, and just walk the dog. Maybe you straighten one leg, bending the other as you lift it off the ground. Take three breaths here. And we're going to inhale, right leg high to three-legged dog. We're going to exhale, bring that knee to chest. Step that foot up between your hands. Drop down on that back leg. We're going to reach the arms overhead. Relax through the shoulders. Place the left hand on that left thigh. And begin to twist open to the left side of the mat. Sink into that hip. Hold for three breaths. Inhale. Frame that front foot. My music shut off. I hate when that happens. Curl the back toes. Slide that leg back. Come into a plank. Drop your knees. Bring them as wide as the mat. Toes touch. Sit back. Melt that chest and forehead. Take three breaths. Let's round that spine, come into a tabletop, curl the toes, come back to your down dog. Take three breaths, bending one knee, straightening the other, lifting that bent knee, really sinking that heel to the mat. You guys feel free to put on your own music. Mine shut off, this is no signal. And anytime I try to turn on my A-L-E-X-A, yeah, it won't allow me to, I mean, it like says copyright issue, so whatever. Anyways, on our next inhale, we're going to lift the left leg to three-legged dog. We're going to exhale, knee to chest, step that foot forward, drop down on that back leg, flatten that foot. Slowly lift the arms overhead, relax the shoulders. Sink into that front hip as you bring that right hand behind you to that right thigh. Open the chest. Hold for three breaths. Looks like it's coming back on, so hopefully I can add some music shortly. We're gonna frame that front foot, curl.
curl the back toes, slide that leg back. Come into a high plank. Drop the knees, bring them as wide as the mat, big toes touch. Sit back, melt that chest and chin, or chest and forehead to the mat. You could also do chin as well, if you wanted. Or stay propped up on your forearms. Take your three breaths. Let's round through that spine, come back to our tabletop. Come back to our down dog, curl the toes. Take three breaths, bend one leg, lift it as you straighten through the other. On your next inhale, we're gonna bring that right leg high, three-legged dog. We're gonna exhale, knee to chest, and lower that bent leg down. Coming into pigeon, slide back on that back leg. Right knee is facing the right side of the mat. Hips are squared to the front. You can choose to stay up on your hands, come down to your forearms, use your block if you need, or melt all the way down, forehead to the mat. Hold for three breaths. Let's prop up on the fingertips as we slide that left arm under that right arm. Left. Hold, please. Left ear to the mat. And hold there for three breaths. I finally can put my music back on. Once you're done with your three breaths, prop up on your fingertips and slide that right arm underneath the left, right ear to the mat, and take three breaths. Slowly begin to pop up on the fingertips, lift that head, and come into a plank. Slide that right leg back. Come on, jeez Louise, really? What the heck? We're gonna drop the knees, bring them as wide as the mat. Oh my God, how can I think? Oh, that's right, because I'm hungover. Hold your extended child's pose for three breaths. There we go. Now we're in business. Gently lift the head, come into tabletop. Curl the toes and come back to down dog. Three breaths, straighten one leg, bend the other as you lift it. We're gonna bring that left leg high, three-legged dog as we inhale. Exhale, knee to chest. We're gonna lower that bent leg down, slide back. Left knee facing the left side of the mat. Hips square to the front in pigeon pose. You can stay up on your hands, come onto your forearms, or melt the chest and forehead down. Three breaths. We're gonna prop up on the fingertips. We're gonna slide the right arm under the left right ear to the mat. Hold for three breaths. Slowly slide that arm out, come back to your fingertips, left arm and left ear under that right arm. Hold for three breaths.
Let's walk those hands in. Curl the back toes. Slide that left leg back. Coming into high plank. We're going to drop the knees down. Swing them around. And slowly lay back.
We're going to bring legs up on a wall. Flex the feet just like you have your legs leaning up against the wall. Hands down by your side. We're going to slightly bend the knees and we're going to open them up and close. The breath into the movement. We're going to come into happy baby. Grab the outsides of both feet. Tailbone stays on the mat, pushing those knees down towards the mat. Feet are flexed. Hold for 3 breaths. You can rock back and forth if you like. And let's place both feet on the mat. We're going to come into bridge pose, so if you want to use your block for that, I recommend bringing the heels as close to the glutes as possible, hands down by your side. We're going to slowly lift the hips towards the sky, keeping the legs in line with the hips. You can place that block underneath your sacrum, keeping the neck nice and long. Hold for 3 breaths. Have a block under you, gently lift up on your toes, slide the block out, and hands back down by your sides, gently coming down one vertebrae at a time. Let's hug the knees into the chest, bring nose to the knees in a little ball, and place both feet on the mat. We're going to bring both knees over to the right, left arm comes out, look over towards that hand. And breathe. Come on back. Take both knees over to the left. Right arm out. Hold for 3 breaths. Both shoulder blades on the mat. Come on back. Let's turn to the right. And gently come up into a seat.
Bringing both feet together in cobbler's pose. If you want, you can use your block here as well. We're going to melt forward. You can rest your head on the block. Or just keep the neck in line with the spine. Take 3 breaths here. And let's walk it over to the right.
Take 3 breaths.
Walk through center, come on over to the left. Hold for 3 breaths. Come back through center. Walk the fingertips in. Come back to your middle split. Sit up nice and tall. Walk those fingertips forward. Either come onto your forearms or rest your head on the block. Flexing those feet.
and take 3 breaths.
Gently lift your head and walk the fingertips back in. Let's come into a seat to finish out our practice. I highly recommend a 10-minute shavasana at the end of our practice, relaxing your body, releasing any tension in your physical or mind, your physical body or your mind, release any tension. Closing your eyes, taking nice, full, deep breaths, slow and controlled, and just closing your mind down, turning off your thoughts, just being in the moment and surrender. We're gonna inhale, reaching the arms overhead. As we do, I want you to picture positive energy just absorbing with each inhale. As you exhale, I want you to picture anything not serving you, releasing. Let's inhale, reach arms overhead. Hold the breath. And exhale, release. Inhale, arms overhead. Tomorrow on the mat. I will be here, so hopefully you'll meet me here. Thank you guys so much, and have a good Labor Day. Namaste. Y'all.